We're at immigration headquarters to find out what future Americans in high-stress situations take for headache pain. Excuse me, what's your name?
Itraka Snay.
Mrs. Itraka Snay. Mrs. Snay, what do you take for headache pain? Mrs. Snay, do you take one of the two leading 600 milligram tablets or our new 800 milligram combination decongestant and painkiller? Well, Mrs. Nay, you picked the new Tylenex 800 milligram decongestant and painkiller.
Mrs. Grosso, can you start work immediately? Did you hear me, Mrs. Grosso? I said, can you start work immediately?
That was meaty.
Yes.
Ooh.
Tylenex. Your headache will disappear like magic.
Mrs. Glorosa, I thought your name was Mrs. Nay.
Tired of ordinary television? Don't touch that dial. SCTV is now on the air. Starring John Candy, Joe Flaherty, Eugene Levy, Andrea Martin, Rick Moranis, Catherine O'Hara, and Dave Thomas. Television like you've never seen it before. This is the SCTV Television Network with special guest violinist Eugene Fedor. And now it's time for Farm Film Celebrity Blow-Up with Big Jim McBob and Billy Saul Hurock.
Howdy, farmers. I'm Big Jim McBob.
And I'm Billy Saul Hurock.
And welcome to Farm Film Celebrity Blow-Up.
Yes, sir. We got a right fine show for you lined up tonight. It's going to be a good one.
Oh, real good.
Yeah, it's going to be real good. Our guest this morning made herself quite a reputation as an actress in such memorable films as Kramer vs. Kramer and Manhattan.
That's right, and one of my favorite films, French Lieutenant's Woman. I'm talking about none other than Meryl Streep, actress, mom, and all-around good looker.
Woo!
Thank you, Big Jim, Billy Saul. I'm really glad to be here.
You know, Meryl, for such a great actress, you know, you sure are pretty. In an unusual kind of way.
Yeah. You got what we call offbeat good looks.
Yeah, you're pretty.
Pretty, in an offbeat kind of way.
Yeah. Well, thank you. I like to think of myself as a serious actress with offbeat good looks.
Well, now, Meryl, you know that Billy Saul and I, we just love to see people blow up in films.
Yeah, blow up good.
Yeah. And you never blowed up in a film before, have you?
No, I've been in a lot of films, and I've cried a lot, but I haven't actually blown up, no.
Yeah, every film I ever seen you in, you was either crying or blowing your nose.
Well, now, I don't know about you, Billy Saul, but I'd love to see Meryl blow up for us right now.
Yeah, blow up real good. Good.
Well, that's all the time we have now. Be sure to join us next week on Farm Film Celebrity Blow Up.
Yeah, we're going to blow up our special guest, Richard Chamberlain.
Oh, I've been wanting to see him blow up for a long time.
That's right. So until next week, this is Billy Saul Hurock.
And Big Jim McBob saying, may the good Lord take a liking to you and blow you up real soon.
New on SCTV, exciting wilderness adventure with Grizzly Abrams. He left his home in the city to live in the forests he loved. It was just him and the woods and the defenseless little creatures that he found and cared for. Helpless but responsive animals with whom he explored nature's deepest secrets. Watch for Grizzly Abrams and his urban friends and The Unexpected, coming soon.
We went to Ellis Island to ask Perini Scleroso to take the Pepsi challenge.
Now, why don't... Yes, go ahead. Yeah, Pretty, which cola do you prefer, cola A or cola B?
Local Abbey.
Right, which one, A or B?
Local Abbey.
No, I want you, here, let me make it easy for you. Did you prefer the Pepsi or the Coke?
Oh, jeez.
Yeah, it's very good. Now, which one did you prefer, the Pepsi or the Coke?
Pepsi.
There we have it, another Pepsi drinker taking the Pepsi challenge here at Ellis Island.
This fall on SCTV, meet Mike Chisel, small town Dick. The only private eye in Punyville. Population 200.
Sanderson, come on in.
Hi, Mike.
Hi. What brings you here?
Mike, I want you to follow my husband.
Oh, Hank? Why?
Because I think he's seeing another woman.
Another woman? Who?
That's what I want you to find out.
Why?
Because you're a detective?
Of course.
Mike, please keep this absolutely private.
Trust me.
How's your mouse percentage?
Just great, just great. The dry air has really helped it out.
Mike Chisel, sleuthing in a town where everybody knows everybody else's business.
Hi, Mike, how are you?
Oh, good, thanks.
How's it going, Mike?
Just fine, thanks.
Hey, Mike! Who are you tailing? Hank Anderson?
Yeah, as a matter of fact.
He's with that tramp, Betty Lou Petty. Everybody knows that. They meet at her place at 2 every day.
Mike Chisel, tough, daring, always a step ahead of everybody else.
Hi, Mikey.
Hiya.
How's the mommy's borositis today?
Oh, not too bad, thanks. You know, that dry weather's really helped it out a lot.
You go to Arizona this year or no?
We don't have to now, you know. That's the great thing about it, you know, the dry weather and all.
Yeah, Mr. Anderson, is he seeing another woman?
So they tell me. Excuse me, Eddie. Hi, Bert.
Hey, Mike.
Hi, Clem.
Mike, how you doing?
Kent,
hi, Mike.
Whoa, Jim.
How's it going, Mike?
Good, good, thanks. What happened here, murder?
Yeah, Mrs. Anderson offed her husband. All right, Bert, take her away. Hope you learn crime doesn't pay.
Bye, Mrs. Anderson.
Bye, Mike.
Bye, Bert.
This is real police business, Mike. You shouldn't be watching this.
I know, I'm just a private investigator.
I know. Hey, listen, I want to ask you, how's your mom's bursitis?
Oh, great. The dry weather's really helped her out a lot.
Yeah, you're going down south this year?
We don't have to. That's the beauty of it.
Great, great. Listen, that Kiwanis Festival on Sunday, you feel like giving me a ride?
Oh, sure, I'd love to.
That'd be great.
Great, about a half hour early?
Yeah.
Oh, sure.
Fun.
Mike Chisel, Small Town Dick, coming this fall to SCTV. And now, SCTV's Movie of the Week, New York Rhapsody, starring classical violinist Eugene Fedor as Paul Bure.
Never had much use for it, except for bathing and drinking it. Other than that, I wouldn't give you 2 cents for it. But ask a fish and I'm sure you'll get a different answer. Oh yeah, by the way, my name's Paul Bure and I got a story to tell. My story. It all started in a New York City tenement.
Be good enough to be a concert violinist.
I kill him. I kill him.
No, Papa, no.
Violin hurt ears. Miss Prong, I kill him.
You leave our son alone. One day people will pay to hear Paul Bure play the violin. I do not want him to grow up and be a butcher like you. Play, son. Play. Bravo. Paul, where are you going?
I'm playing at a society party. This could be a big break for me.
Paul! What watch out for those society women. They're bad. They'll eat you up and spit you out so fast your head will spin. They drink too much. They smoke too much. They'll marry you 20 times and divorce you 40.
Look, Mom, how can you get divorced more times than you're married?
Paul, no society dames. No society dames. Now, have fun and play good, my son.
Okay, good night.
Sissy musician, bum!
Papa, when will you stop hating our son? What will it take for you to love him?
Him play Carnegie Hall. Me lay off.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I have your attention, please? Ladies and gentlemen, I have a very important announcement to make here. Okay, come on, put a lid on it. I got something to say here. You want? Everybody can just pipe down for a second. Come on, shut up! Gives me great pleasure to introduce a guy who's, he's a real virtuoso, and, I think it's swell that he's decided to honor us with a short selection this evening. So would you join me in, giving a nice, warm welcome to Mr. Paul Ballray!
Mr. Beret, but what else can they do? So where are you from?
I'm a native New Yorker.
Oh, what do we have here, fellas? A rare worm from the Big Apple.
Yeah, well, you hook a lot of things with worms, even a high society carp like you.
If that was supposed to be an insult, Mr. Beret, let me warn you. I'm not easily insulted.
Oh, yeah? How about this? Bronco Nagurski called. He wants his shoulders back. Oh, by the way, you dropped your eyebrow pencil. What's your problem, lady?
Problem? I'm married to a weakling. Oh, he's nice enough. But he's not you, Paul. You're coarse, you're vulgar, and you're the best damn violinist in this country.
Yeah, a lot of good it's gonna do me. I don't even have a manager.
Let me take care of that. I'll be your patron. I've got unlimited cash flow.
Yeah, sure.
Would you like a drink?
I don't drink.
A cigarette?
I don't smoke.
You've got a lot to learn, Mr. Boré. A lot.
Stay tuned to SCTV for the dramatic conclusion to New York Rhapsody.
We're at the home of Mrs. Joan Davis to show her that Shine detergent will get her dishes so clean she'll be able to see her own reflection.
Oh.
Mrs. Davis, those dishes are beautiful. Tell me, what detergent do you use?
Itarajan Turji, Asuyu.
What detergent?
Itarajan Turji.
Yes, Mrs. Davis uses Shine detergent. It cuts through grease and grime and leaves her dishes so clean.
What are you doing here?
We're at the home of Mrs. Joan Davis to prove that she can see her face in a dish. And what is your name?
I'm Joan Davis. That is my cleaning lady, Mrs. Snake.
Hi, Snake. Hi.
You people aren't from the Department of Immigration, are you? Because I can assure you that we do not exploit our help in...
Mrs. Name, where are you going?
Back at 10.
You're not going. You have...
Yes, proof positive that Shine detergent cuts through grease and grime and leaves your dishes so clean you can see your own reflection.
Gentergy.
And now, SCTV proudly presents the dramatic conclusion to New York Rhapsody, starring Eugene Fedor.
Coming here, lady.
Mom Bray, please, I must talk to you.
I've got nothing to say to you.
Mama, you've got to listen to me.
I don't have to listen to you. Ruined my son. And now you come traipsing in here with your high society fashions and your big shoulders and your oversized eyebrows.
Her got good eyebrows. You should have eyebrows so lush.
Throw her out. Throw her out!
I'm warning you. You come up the middle on me and I'll stuff you.
That's a solid hit.
Mom, we both know I'm no good for your son, but I can't help myself. I can't keep my mitts off him. Every time I get my hooks into one of these geniuses, I turn him into a chain-smoking wino. You've got to stop me before I destroy him.
You must atone for your sins in your own way.
But how?
I suggest you kill yourself.
Thank you, Mama. For once in my life, I shan't be thinking only of myself.
Oh, and Helen, one more thing.
Yes, Mama.
That's for the cheap shot you put on my husband.
Thank you.
there you have it. A pretty sad story. I guess Mom was right about those society dames. But you know, when they fished her out of that whirlpool, I knew she gave her life for me. I don't know, sometimes life don't make no sense. By the way, I married that dame in the front row. She was another fish in the sea. I guess Mom was right about that too, I guess.
The next Sammy Maudlin show is hilarious.
I love you, Sammy Maudlin. I want to bury our children.
But it's no laughing matter as Bobby Bittman talks about drug abuse.
I don't know about you, Sammy, but when I get paid with the green stuff. I don't get paid with the white stuff.
Oh. And Hollywood secrets are revealed.
I took the liberty of documenting those horrible days in a book.
All this and more, coming soon.